ब्यूटिफुल मॉर्निंग टू माई लवली बेटांस. हाउ आर यू ऑल? गुड? हैप्पी? आई एम ऑल्सो गुड बेटा. डियर किड्स, एज यू नो वी आर स्टडिंग चैप्टर 12 मेजरमेंट ऑफ आर साइंस बुक. एंड यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट वॉट इज मेजरमेंट, वॉट इज इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट, हाउ वी कैन मेजर द थिंग्स, हाउ मेजरमेंट हेल्प्स अस इन आर डे टू डे लाइफ, and how we use measurement in our day-to-day life. So, by continuing with the topic, today we will study about measurement of length. But beta, before going to measurement of length, again I want you to take on units of measurements. As I told you, we have different units to measure different objects. But there are two types of units. One are standard units and another one are non-standard units. Now you will think, what are these? Ma'am hasn't told us about standard units and non-standard units. Yes, so today ma'am will tell you what are standard units and what are non-standard units. Standard units are those units, beta, which remain same throughout the world and for everyone, like centimeter, meter and kilometer. We know 1 meter equals to 100 centimeter, 1 kilometer equals to 1000 meter. This fact is same for everyone, for the entire world. So these units are known as standard units. But we have some non-standard units also to measure the length. What are these? The non-standard units are hand span. Now, what is the hand span? Hand span is this, the difference between your thumb and your short finger. This is known as hand span. Now, the second non-standard unit is cubit. Now, what is cubit? Cubit is the distance from your elbow to the middle finger. Distance from your elbow to the middle finger. This is cubit. And we have pace. What is pace? Pace is the distance between your 2 feet when you walk. The distance between your 2 feet is known as pace. So beta, these units are non-standard units. Now here one question arises. Why these units are called non-standard units? Yes beta. So I am going to tell you the answer of your question. These units are non-standard units because they are not same. As you can feel that, see, if my hand span is this, the distance from this and this, it will not remain same for everyone. If you will measure your hand span's distance, that then obviously it will be different. It will differ by each and every person. Because these units are not same with everyone, that's why these units are called non-standard units. So I'll tell you the standard units and non-standard units of length in detail. So come, let's begin the class.
Let's understand what length is and how to measure it. The word length is used to measure how long an object is. For example, length of the classroom floor, length of the blackboard, length of a pencil, etc. It is also used to measure distances. For example, distance from your home to school, distance between two cities or countries. Measuring length. We can use the hand span, the foot span, or the cubit to measure smaller lengths. What do you mean by hand span? Hand span is the distance from the tip of the thumb to the tip of the little finger on an outstretched hand. Lisa is measuring her maths textbook with the help of hand span. Let's measure. 1, 2. So, the length of her maths textbook is 2 hand spans. Now, let's see what you mean by foot span. Foot span is the distance from the tip of the toe to the heel of the foot. Look, Lisa is measuring the length of the classroom with her foot span. Let's measure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So, the length of the classroom is 20 foot spans. Now, let's see how to measure with cubit. Cubit is the length from the elbow to the end of the fingers. Now, Lisa is measuring the side of the table with her cubit. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, the length of the side of the table is 4 cubits. You too can measure the lengths with your body parts and have fun.
Now we will study measurement of length and the standard units of length. In our day-to-day work, we use a scale to measure small length. Example, a line drawn on a notebook. See beta, you all have this tool with you. This is a ruler, a scale, and we all use this scale in our day-to-day work, to do work in our notebook, to draw lines, to measure the line segment, sometime to measure the length of our pencil, our sharpener, our eraser. As a fun, we use scale. So we use scale in our day-to-day life to measure the length of the small objects and to draw lines also. When you go to the market to buy clothes with your mother, you ask for cloth in meters. Yes, beta, if you have ever gone with your mama to the market to buy clothes, so there you need to ask for the cloth in meters, because the cloth merchant sells cloth in meters. So you need to ask him that how much meter you need, you require. The cloth merchant measures it with the help of a meter scale. See, this is a meter scale. This is also a scale. So the cloth merchant measures it with the help of a meter scale. Example, 4 meter of cloth. So if we require 4 meter of cloth, so he will measure it with the scale and will give the cloth to us. For relatively bigger distances, we use kilometers as the unit. Yes, beta. For very small lengths, we use centimeter. For small lengths, we use meter. But for the bigger distances, we use kilometer as the unit. Example, distance between Jalandhar and Amritsar is 80 kilometer. So, here km means kilometers. Means km is the short form of kilometers. Now, what we have concluded, what we have learned, for very small lengths, the unit should be cm. And what is the full form of cm? Centimeter. For small lengths, the unit should be meter. What is the short form of meter? M. M stands for meters. And for measuring the bigger lengths, the distances, we use kilometers. And what is the short form of kilometers? Km. Means km stands for kilometers. Now beta, how these units are related to each other? You should understand that how these units are related to each other. What is the relation between the units of length, dear kids? 1 kilometer. Kilometer is the biggest unit. 1 kilometer equals to 1000 meters. That means there are 1000 meters in 1 kilometer. And now meter is bigger than centimeter. So what is the relation between meter and centimeter? 1 meter equals to 100 centimeter. Because centimeter is smaller than meter. So there are 100 centimeters in 1 meter. So beta, these units are also interconnected with each other. Centimeter is the smallest one, then meter, and then kilometer. So this is the relation between the units of length. Today we have came across the measurement of length, and we got to know what are standard units and what are non-standard units. So your homework is to read page number 124 carefully, and you can observe the difference between non-standard units and standard units by practicing it at your home. So you can practice with the objects, so you will get to know about the practical implementation of the things we have studied. So do your homework, be safe, be happy at your home. We will meet soon. Till then, goodbye.